Public art evokes a feeling. It is subjective and often controversial.
Public art provides us with an opportunity to have a private moment in a public space.
The City of Reno's municipal code provides that 2% of the construction budget on a capital improvement project be earmarked for public art. And in those cases where the capital improvement project is too small or the art would not be visible, that money goes into what is called an enterprise fund, in which the city, developers, and other entities can apply for a matching grant to put up some public art as well. Stacy showed us some of the mock-ups made by artists who have submitted proposals to the city. There is an extensive public process in choosing public art. It starts with a small, specific panel made up of professionals and persons with an interest in a particular project. The panel narrows down the selection and gives its recommendations to a public art committee of the Arts and Culture Commission.
That decision then goes to the Arts and Culture Commission as a whole to look at and ratify. And again, at that level, they can say yes, no, send something back for clarification, say, we really like this idea, but can you think about doing something about the climbability of this piece? Or we really appreciate this aesthetic, but we wonder if graffiti would be an issue with this piece. So, all of those questions are asked all along the way, and then when a finalist has reached that point, the finalist selected goes to the City Council for their review and approval.
The reviewing groups consider many things and ask a lot of questions before they choose a final design.
Artists need to know how to communicate to a wide variety of people, from just members of the public to, folks on our panel are landscape architects and architects and practicing artists in the field, and, folks who work in park planning who may think about things like, well, how's that going to stand up to getting watered every third day? So there are so many questions that artists have to be able to answer right away and to give folks confidence that their piece is going to be a 50 or 100-year-old decision. So these are big choices for a city, and we have the responsibility to make sure that they're the finest possible quality of workmanship and design, so that, they do stand up.
Each piece of public art becomes part of a collection in which the city is the curator.
Different genres, different styles, different design aesthetics, different materials that people can appreciate as they're going through the collection, so that it's not, oh, same old, oh yeah, oh, there's another one of the, oh, there's another one of those. They're able to say, wow, that's different. Oh my gosh, how did they get that? And I think that it when you get to look at it as a collection, you're able to be very inclusive, bring in more artists. International, national, regional, local.
It is the citizens' collection. It is the City of Reno public art collection. So it's their collection. So they should feel that folks should feel that it's that some ownership of it and get involved.
To find out more about Reno's public art and how you can get involved in future projects, call 334-INFO.